Hello friends, good morning. In the last class, we studied which are the important concepts of national income and what's the importance of national income and why do we calculate national income, etc. You know that most of your parents are doing different types of jobs. In your lower classes, you studied the important categories or the important sections of jobs in our country. Not only in our country, all parts of the world, there are three types of or three sectors of jobs. Which are they? Can you say? Yes. Which are they? Primary, secondary, and tertiary works. Okay. So, our government also collects a lot of cash from these three sectors. You know that India is a very big country. So, a lot of people are living here and they are going to do different types of work. So, it's not so easy for our government to calculate the income from all different sources. But it's a necessary one to calculate the income from different sources. Even then, there are so many difficulties. It's the duty of our government to calculate national income for the development of our country. If there is no calculation, our government has no plan to implement for the development of our country. Okay, so today we can study how to calculate the national income and what are the important difficulties we have to suffer when we calculate national income. Okay, so today Aisha Banu is going to lead your class. She is ready to say some words related with these topics. Okay, so we can invite Aisha Banu for leading your class. Aisha Banu, please come here and share your points here.
Hi guys, good morning to all. It's me, Aisha Banu. In the last class, we have discussed what is national income and what are the important concepts of national income. Today, we are going to study how to calculate national income and what are the important difficulties in calculating the national income. We know that economic condition of a country is calculated on the basis of its national income. If the national income is very high, we can say the country is highly developed one. If the national income is very low, we can say the country is underdeveloped one. Clear? Okay. So for each and every country, it is necessary to increase production for its economic prosperity or its economic growth. In the previous classes, we learned the important factors of production. Do you remember that? Which are the important factors of production? Yes, land, labor, capital, and organization. Very good. These are the important factors of production. We know that, right? Okay. When production increases, the rewards of factors of production also increase. When rewards increase, the expenditure automatically increase. When expenditure increase, again production increase. It is like a rotating or flowing activity. Look at here. When production increases, the income also increases. When income increases, again expenditure also increases. When expenditure increases, production also increases. Then again income increases. And then again expenditure also increases. By looking this diagram, we can understand that the production and income and expenditure are interrelated. Okay? Now we know how to calculate a national income of a country with the help of these three aspects. Okay. Now we study more details about these three methods. Okay. So first of all, we can take product method. We know that a country gets income from primary, secondary and tertiary sectors. We know that because what type of job we are going to do, it belongs to primary, secondary and tertiary sectors. Under the product method, the national income calculated by adding of the money values of goods and services produced by these sectors, that is from primary, secondary and tertiary sectors. This method is called a product method. So remember that under this method, national income calculated by adding the money values of goods and services. Okay, so please study that word, the money values of goods and services. Okay. We already studied what is money values of goods and services from different sectors. Okay, by adding the money values of goods and services, we know how to calculate a national income of a country. Okay, this method is also help us to identify the contribution of each sectors towards the national income and It also helps us to understand which sectors contribute more to the national income. Okay, first one, it is useful to identify the contribution of each sectors to the national income. And second one, it is help us to understand which sector contributes more to the national income. That means maybe primary sectors contribute more to the national income, or maybe tertiary sectors contribute more to the national income. It is the important uses of product method. Okay, next we can study another method for calculating the national income, that is income method. We know that what type of job we do, we may get four types of rewards. It may be rent or wage or interest or profit. So we can say the rent, wage, interest, profit are the different types of income. That a person or different pupils may get from their works. In this method, the national income calculates on the basis of these four factors of production. Which are the factors of production? Yes, rent, wage, interest and profit. Okay. This method is so helpful or so useful in analyzing the contribution of each factors of production to the national income. So, when we calculate the national income through this method, we can understand that whether the land supports the national income or labor supports the national income, etc. It's the importance of income method. Okay, clear? Okay, now we can study another method for calculating the national income. That is expenditure method. A lot of cash we are spending in our daily needs. Likewise, different firms or institutions are also spend lot of cash for their own daily needs. Likewise, our government also spent a lot of cash for the welfare of people and the production of country, etc. By adding the expenditure of individuals, institutions and the government, we can easily calculate the national income. So expenditure mainly calculates the expenditure of individuals, institutions and the government for calculating the national income. In economics, the consumption expenditure and investment are also included in the expenditure. We know that a country have three types of expenditures, which are the first one, consumption expenditure. That means the people, institution or government use cash for different types of goods and services. That's the consumption expenditure. And another expenditure is investment expenditure. Sometimes people may spend cash for investment, institutions and organizations. Likewise, our government also spend cash for investment. This is the investment expenditure. When we calculate the national income by the adding of expenditure of people or the expenditure of government or the expenditure of institutions, whatever may be, the national income will be same or will be get the same result. That means that's the importance of expenditure method. So once again, listen here. When we calculate the national income by adding the expenditure and expenditure of individuals, institutions and the government, we can easily calculate the national income. First one, lack of reliable statistical data. That means when we visit a family or institution for calculating the national income, that didn't give a correct information. That means we didn't get a real situation of a particular family or a particular firm. It is an important problem when we calculate the national income. And second one, double counting. There is a chance for calculating the money values of goods and services more than once while they are passing the different stages of production. So the double counting is a major problem when we calculate the national income. And third one, services of houses wives. We know that in each and every houses our mothers doing different types of works. Even she get any reward, her works also a work. So that work or that services we do not include when we calculate the national income. Fifth one, keeping inaccurate records. That means The most of the consumers do not maintain the records of expenditures. That means consumers include most of the business people and the high rich firms, because that means most of the conditions they are leading their business very well, and their income will be very high and their profit will be very high, because that the people not ready to pay the correct tax for government, and they cheat government some malpractices doing. So it is so difficult to calculate the national income of their peoples incorrectly, and what is the correct expenditure of the family or that people. It also adversely affected the calculate national income. Okay, now I am going to wind up here. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.